get a big ball here.
If you saw it on the sidewalk, you'd walk away from it.
Because something like a clogged drain really isn't that big of a job, but I got to charge him for coming out there. I'll be more than happy to come on out.
The best liquid drain opener is in the gray bottle. Professional Strength Liquid Plumber.
Today is the last of the debates. I am going to predict that John McCain is going to scream. Barack Obama, at the very end, is not going to be able to resist the urge to do a little pop and lock.
Boring. I want John McCain to be put on the spot about his vice presidential pick. I hope that the candidates challenge one another. I hope that it will be moderated well.
Sean has made almost all accurate predictions. You predicted that Joe Biden would cry, but I actually completely dismiss what you said. And yet at the same time, you're always right.
Cool.
This is Flossie's completed first panel of the Doctor Who police box that she's been knitting during the debates. Do you think that the whole Palin, the whole thing, the whole terrorist thing, which got its job done because it put that out there, clearly those people were off their rockers. Well, so they went for those people to show how magnanimous he is to build this up.
I think that's a really good assessment.
I don't know, I think he is going to bring up Eris.
You do?
I do.
The situation we're in with the economy, put your Visa card away and you need to start living within your means, because the reason we're in this situation is because of you. And that's something that neither candidate has done yet.
And that's why I'm sure that our brighter days are still ahead.
But also is going to enforce on fair trade agreements.
Are each of you tonight willing to sit at this table and say to each other's face what your campaigns and the people in your campaigns have said about each other?
I got nervous. I thought I was going to have a heart attack at one point. It was very confrontational, and McCain freaked me out. As if he was just a normal 72-year-old, I'd say go for it, you know? But he's all hobbled and fucked up and food deprived and water deprived and oxygen deprived. This man is no business even sitting at a table with Bob Schieffer's mother.
His best response all night long was, "If it sounds incredible that I would not defend the lives of babies that needed life-saving medical treatment, it's because it's not true."
Barack Obama did pop and lock at the end.
I think McCain did pop and lock at the end.
Not boring. Joe, you're rich.
Oh, and Joe the plumber.
I want to meet Joe the plumber. I want to meet Senator Government.
And I think we need to thank Hillary Clinton tonight, because without her, I don't know if Barack Obama would have been as prepared. Her points were made in this debate at one point when he talked about equal pay for equal work. And McCain tried to usurp Clinton at one point, usurp Obama by using Clinton's name, and it didn't work.
I love my friends so much, but I feel like we do not have our finger on the pulse of what is happening in this country at all.
We actually tape our own opinions and then watch them.
I'm right.
Your official correspondence for Debate Porridge.
You're in.
Sarah Hirsch, out.
And I promise you that if you give me the extraordinary honor of serving as your president, I will work every single day tirelessly on your behalf and on the behalf of the future of our children.
It's been the great honor of my life, and I've been proud to serve, and I hope you'll give me an opportunity to serve again. I'd be honored and humbled.
Be sure to follow Debate Porridge on Tumblr, Twitter, and Facebook.